Welcome. Myself Gridhar Jain, Assistant Professor in Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, Walchen Institute of Technology, Solapur. Now today I am going to deliver a lecture on CMOS logic. Now learning outcomes of the session are, at the end of the session, students will be able to draw construction of CMOS inverter and describe its working. Second outcome is, students will be able to design logic gates using CMOS logic. Then this is the symbol of n-channel e-MOSFET. Okay, now this symbol of n-channel e-MOSFET is simplified as shown in right hand side. So this is symbol of n-channel e, simplified n-channel e-MOSFET symbol used in VLSI. Okay, so that substrate which is shown by the dotted line, so that is not used here, right? So this symbol for the n-channel MOSFET is used in VLSI, and below that you can see the symbol for the p-channel e-MOSFET used in VLSI. So this is circuit for CMOS inverter. So drain of two MOSFETs are connected together, which will be the output. Source of p-MOSFET is connected to the VDD, and the source of N MOSFET connected to the ground as shown in figure, and the gate of PMOS and NMOS connected together where input is applied. So this is circuit of CMOS inverter. Now construction of the CMOS inverter is shown in the below diagram. Now here we start with a P substrate. Okay, now for this P substrate, onto this P substrate, so N plus and N plus, two heavily doped N regions are obtained by diffusion. One of them is drain and other is source. So right hand side is source and this is a drain, and in between insulating layer of SiO2, polysilicon and gate. So this is a N channel E MOSFET fabricated. Now for fabrication of the P channel E MOSFET, we start with N substrate. But here already we have started with P substrate. So what is done? A N well is obtained by diffusion onto this P substrate. So that is N well. And onto this N well, two heavily doped P regions are obtained by diffusion. One of them is right hand side is a drain and left hand side is source for P channel E MOSFET. Then in between these two, insulating layer of SiO2, then polysilicon gate. Now drain of two MOSFETs are connected together where we can take the output. Gate of two MOSFETs connected together where we can apply the input. The source of the P MOSFET goes to plus VDD. Source of NMOS goes to ground, means the connections are made during the fabrication according to the circuit of CMOS inverter. So this is the fabrication or construction diagram of the CMOS inverter. Okay, now using CMOS logic or using CMOS, we can implement the various gates. Now here let us take the example of two input NAND gate. So NAND gate is given by Y equal to AB bar by De Morgan's theorem. AB bar is equal to A bar plus B bar, right? And this is the circuit diagram for the two input NAND gate. Now you can verify whether the circuit works as a two input NAND gate or not. Now two p-mosfets are connected in parallel, right? And the source of this 2 pMOS goes to plus VDD, drain of 2 pMOS that goes to the output. Then from output, 2 nMOS are connected in series as shown. Now input A is applied to the gate of this pMOS and this nMOS. Similarly, input B applied to the gate of this pMOS and this nMOS as shown in figure. So this is A and B are the inputs and Y is the output. Now if both input are zero, okay, then upper 2 pMOS are conducting. If these 2 pMOS are conducting, then output Y is getting connected to the VDD and therefore output is logic 1. Now if input is 0 1, means A is 0 and B is 1, then this PMOS will conduct, this will not conduct, therefore output is again getting connected to the VDD, means output is logic 1. If input is 1 0, right, or 0 1, A is 0 and B is 1, then next is A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0, so this PMOS will conduct. And if input is A and B are 1 1, then PMOS, upper 2 pMOS will not conduct and the lower 2 nMOS will conduct, therefore output is getting connected to the ground. So in this way the circuit works as a 2-input NAND gate, means output, right, so Y is equal to AB bar, means if both inputs are 1, right, then output is 0. If both inputs are 1, then output is 0. Under all other condition, the output is 1. Okay. Now pause this video and think on the following question. What will be the circuit for 2-input NOR gate? Now circuit for 2-input NOR gate. So already we have designed 2-input NAND gate. So here 2 pMOS are connected in series for the upper one, and below from output to the ground 2 nMOS are connected in parallel. Okay, so this is input A, input B, VDD and VSS. So Y is equal to A plus B bar. By De Morgan's theorem, this is equal to A bar into B bar. Okay, and this is the circuit for 2-input NOR gate. Now actually for the CMOS logic, from output to the VDD, whatever is the circuit that we call as a pull-up network, which is designed using only PMOS, and from output to the ground, whatever is the circuit that we call as a pull-down network, so pull-down network is designed using only NMOS. Okay, pull-up network will connect the output to the VDD and pull-down network will connect the output to the ground. And pull-up network and pull-down network are duals of each other. Okay, means in the pull-up network 2 pMOS are connected in series, so in a pull-down network 2 nMOS are connected in parallel. So instead of pMOS, nMOS, instead of series, parallel, so they are duals of each other. Okay, so this is the general block schematic of CMOS logic. So pull-up network or a circuit using only PMOS, and the pull-down network or circuit using only NMOS. Then pull-up network goes to VDD, pull-down network goes to ground, and in between pull-up network and pull-down network, output is taken and you apply the common input to gate of MOSFETs in the pull-up network and the pull-down network. So this is block schematic for the CMOS logic. Okay, so in this way, using CMOS logic, we can implement any gate or any Boolean expression can be implemented. Now let us implement two input AND gate using CMOS logic. Already we have implemented the two input NAND gate. So what I have done, I have drawn two input NAND gate as it is. So output of two input NAND gate is Y dash is equal to AB bar. And already we know the inverter, CMOS inverter, okay? So output of NAND gate is passed through a CMOS inverter, means it is inverted. Therefore, the output of CMOS inverter is nothing but Y is equal to AB. So in this way, this is two input AND gate. Similarly, two input OR gate can be designed by using the two input NOR gate followed by CMOS inverter. Okay? So this is the these are references. Thank you for watching the video.